हेलो, वेलकम टू दिस चैनल गेन जावा नॉलेज। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू हैंडल एक्सेप्शन इन स्प्रिंग वेब फ्लक्स फंक्शनल स्टाइल प्रोग्रामिंग। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड वन स्प्रिंग वेब फ्लक्स प्रोजेक्ट। सो हेयर वी कैन सी आई हैव डिफाइंड मल्टीपल फंक्शनल एंड पॉइंट इन आवर स्प्रिंग बूट प्रोजेक्ट। So here we can see, here we have defined four APIs using functional endpoint programming. Now today we are going to learn how to handle exceptions for these functional endpoint at global level. For to do this, only we need to take two steps, or we can say we need to create only two classes to handle exception at global level. So what I will do, first here I will create one package. New package, new class. So here I will define one package, that is exception handler, and here I will create one class, that is global exception handler. But before implementing this exception handler, I want to show how my API is working before this exception handler. So here we can see, here I have created four APIs, get all student and get student by ID and add student. So first I will start my application and run the application, and we'll check how its API is behaving before exception handler. So what I will do, I will go to get all student API, and here I will remove this. And here I will just throw the one exception, throw new runtime exception. So we will see here how this is behaving before exception handler. So here I will just add one message, get student API failed due to some reason. So now I will start my application, run as Java application. So here we can see our application is going start, and application has started at port number 8080. Now I will go and open its Swagger implementation. So here I will go to application.properties, and from here I will just copy the path of our Swagger and go here localhost 8080, and here I will just hit this endpoint. So here we can see our all APIs. So here I have added the exception in that API, get all students. So here I will go and try it out and execute. So here we can see the response that we are getting 500 internal server error, and we are getting some map values. This is a map key as a string, and this is the object. So here path is this, status 500, error internal server error, and requested ID is this. But here we can see in our code we have thrown one exception, that is runtime exception, and we have passed this message, but we are not getting this message in our response. So if you want to get the same message in our API response, then we need to add one property in our application.properties file. So here I will go to application.properties file, and here I will add one more property, server.error include message enable, include message will always. Now I will stop my server and start application again. So here we can see we are not getting the message that we have thrown from our exception. But now I will start and check it again, run as Java application, and now I will go back to our Swagger and execute and check it again. So here we can see now we are getting the message get student API failed that we have passed from here. So we have sent this message from here. So this is the default behavior that was handled by default error web exception handler. So Spring Webflux internally using default error web exception handler class that we can see here. So here we can see default error web exception handler class. And if I will go to the implementation of this class, so in this class we can see this class has extended abstract error web exception handler. So this class is returning the response that we are getting here. So if you want to change the format of this response, then we need to override this class, that is abstract exception handler. So I will copy it and will override. So here I will go and go to this class, and at this class I will just extend this class, and here I will just add the rate component annotation, so our Spring application will understand and will create the bean for this global exception handler class. Now I will just add the constructor for this class. So here I will go back, and we need to add this exception handler constructor. So after adding, it's again showing some error. We need to add unimplemented method also that we need to override. So here I have added one class. In this class I have added one constructor and also added one routing function that we need to override. But here in this constructor we also need to pass one more object, that is server configurer object. If you will not add, then it will throw some exception. So we must need to add this configurer also if you want to override this class. So here what I will do, I will just call this dot set reader and writer we need to set. So first I will set writer, and we will get writer from configurer dot get writers, and here also we need to add reader, set readers. So we will get the list of readers from our configurer object, get readers. So we need to do this only. So inside this function, what we need to do, we need to define the path for which API we want to handle the global exception. So what I will do here, so first here I will just create the object for router functions and need to define the path of API. So router functions dot route. So here if we want to define specific path, then we need to call route method. If we want to define request predicate for all API, then I will use this. So here what I will do, here I will use request predicate, and request predicate for all API. So here request predicates dot all, here I am using this exception handler for all API request, and here we need to call the method. So here I will just define one method, render error response. So we need to create this method in the same class. So because I have declared here this, so just create. Just copy this function, and here we can define one private function, private. So here we just need to define mono as a server response will be returned, mono server response, and here we just need to define the method name, and here we need to pass the variable as a server request. So it will be the server request, and inside this method we need to pass also error attributes. So here we can see, here it's showing some compile time error. So first we need to import the classes. So here now we will format the code. Now what we need to do next, we need to add that we want to return as a object map we want to return. So here I will just add the parameter string comma object, and here our error properties that we want to return will be here. Now next we will get this error attribute, get error attributes, and here we just need to pass two parameters. One is the request that we are getting as a server request, and second we need to pass error attribute options default value. Error attributes options dot defaults value, so it will get all the default value. And after that we need to return server response. So server response, we will set status code also here. Status, what status we want to set? HTTP status dot bad request, and what type of content type we can pass from here. Content type we can set media type as a JSON value. Application.json, and next we can also add the body, and inside body we can pass body inserter. So here what we will do, body inserter, that we need to call this class body inserters dot form value. So form from data, and here we need to add this map error properties. And just close this. Here it's showing some compile time error. So here we need to use from value. From value, so I will change it. So now I will format it. Control Shift F. Now here we can see we have implemented our own exception handler to override the message. So now we will get bad request when an exception will occur. And bad request will send the status code 400. Now I will test our application. So here I will go run as Java application. Cancel student handler is showing some compile time error. So first we need to remove it. Now need to start it again. So here I will run as Java application. So here our application is starting. So here we can see our application has started, not started, that port is already in use. So we need to stop our service first and need to start our server it again. So here I will go and start. Now I will go to our browser, and here I will just hit this REST endpoint and just execute get all student API. Get all students. So here we can see we are getting response as 400 bad request. So if you want to send any other response status like 500, then we just need to update here. Go to global exception handler, and here what we can do, we can change. If I will send internal server error, then it will send me back response code status 500. So here we are seeing 400 bad request. Now we have updated internal server error. So I will stop the service again and check it again. So now start the application. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Go to get API, get all students, and execute. So here we can see now we are getting 500 internal server error. And this is the path, status, error, request ID, and timestamp. But now here we can see we are not getting message. Why we are not getting message? Here we can see because the default exception handler we are using here. Inside get error attributes, we can see its implementation. Why we are not getting the message? So I will open this method. So here we can see error attribute options dot default method, and we can see the implementation. And here it just returning of method, and inside this method it's just returning one map object, that is empty object, default error attributes. So inside this map we can see if we are getting the message in our response, then it will remove error attributes dot remove. This is the key that they have removed. So in our response we are not getting message, timestamp, path, status, error, request ID we are getting. But after adding implementation for this exception handler class, we are not getting message because they have removed. But if we want to send back message in our response, then we need to override error attribute class of Spring Web Flux. So here I will go and create one more class inside the same package. So what I will do here, I will just go to our exception handler package, and here I will create one new class. So here I will create one class, global error attributes, and this class will extend one more class, that is default error attribute, extends default error attributes, default error attribute. So we need to extend this class. And inside this class we can go and see the methods, what methods are getting executed. So we can override this method. So I will copy this method from here, copy and go to my class, and here I will just override and remove this implementation from here. And now what I will do, I will just remove it. And here I will just create new linked hash map. So order will be maintained, in which order we will insert, in same order we will get linked hash map. So this is our map that we will return in the response after overriding this method. So now we want to return message also. So first we need to read the error from our request. So here I will get the error. Error is equal to new error. So here we need to call get error method, and here we need to pass the request as an object. From this request we will get error object, and from this error we will get message. Now I will copy error attributes, and here I will just call put method, and here I will add the key message, and here it will get the message. So now I will, so here we need to close one more bracket. So in our response now we will just get the message. So what I will do, I will stop my application and start the server again. So our application has already stopped. So now I just need to run my application, and we'll check the response again, what we are getting in our response. So our application has started. Here we can see, now I will go to Swagger, and here we can see this is our get all student API. Now I will just execute, and in response now we can see we are getting everything. We can see our class is not working, so we need to check here also. We need to add the red component annotation, then only Spring will understand. So I will stop the server again and need to start it again. So once the application will start, we will check it again. So here we can see our application has started. Now I will execute this API again. So here we can see the response. Now we are just getting the message get student API failed. Like this we can add multiple properties according to our requirement. So if you want to add few more property, then we can also add here using this attributes map. So we just need to add attribute map dot put. Like we can print here path of our API, path that we will get from request dot get request dot path, and also we can add more properties like error attributes dot put, and here we can add like error. Multiple properties we can add in map. So bad request. So now I will stop and check the response again. Now we will get these three properties in response. So I will start application. So our application has started. Now what I will do, I will just call this API. So in the response we can see now I am getting the message, path and error, these three properties that we have overridden here. So like this we can do anything with global exception handler. So this was about how to handle exception in Spring Web Flux functional endpoint. Thanks for watching this video.